Hello everyone. Today we are going to take a look at these two new phase girls, like no other, Nadja and your motivation, Erin. They did not come together. They were sold separately, but they were announced together, and I believe they counted as one of the W Club dolls from 2019. I was so excited for two reasons, because their characters are best friends, so it was really cool to see them together. And I also obviously got super, super excited because of Nadja's look. She is in the Nubian skin tone, which we have not seen for a long time. No idea why, but I think it must have something to do with the factories. Let's talk about Nadja first. Oh my god. When I first opened her, I thought she was absolutely beautiful, but there is something about her that I find really cute. So she has this really beautiful face up. She has black smoky eye shadow, and then she has some gold in the inner corner and an eyeshadow part as well, which is very interesting, unique style of makeup that I have not seen on a doll in a while, but I think it looks really good on her. It makes her eyes stand out a lot, which is really refreshing and nice. And then she has this metallic pink lip color, which looks really good on her. I'm glad they went with a metallic color, because I think if they had just made it regular light pink, it would not have looked that good. But anyways, another thing that I really, really love about this doll is the fact that they did not only dark eyebrows, but also dark hair. Very happy about that. Not just dark hair, but very long, so you can see it goes all the way down basically to about her thighs, so that gives you a lot of options for restyling her hair. Very happy about that. And then she comes with, of course, some jewelry. She included a ring, earrings, and hair clips. Here we see her earrings, which are kind of shaped like bobby pins, which is pretty cute, and they do have that sort of Versace face on them. We can also see that design on her hair clips as well, and on her ring. And then while we're down here, you can see her nails match her lip color. We have this pink cheetah top and black vinyl shorts with a belt that has a golden buckle. And she has this armband over here. Not really sure what the purpose of the armband is. I think I would have preferred a regular purse, but this is something unique, so I definitely appreciate them trying something new. But like I said, I would have preferred a regular purse. And then she comes with this fur throw thingy, which I'm not really a fan of. It's not ugly, it's just that I personally don't see myself using it. Her outfit is very 90s, and maybe that's another thing that makes her look cute. I just think this is such a fantastic doll. I think she might be my favorite. And then of course she comes with extra hands as always, and we can definitely, definitely take a look at her shoes. They are not to be missed. So here are her shoes, which I absolutely love. They are little boots with buckles and straps on the side and little studs. Very, very nice. I love black shoes, and I love black and gold together. I love not having to do zippers or any of that mess, because they do tend to break. I think she has a lot of redress potential. If you're looking to redress her, her top, even though it's very cute, is kind of hard to remove. I'm starting to wonder if these dolls are meant to be redressed or not. It looks like this is kind of sewn into the top, so you will have to take it apart a little bit. Unfortunately, there's no closure on this little scarf part. And now let's take a look at her bestie, Erin. You might not know, I'm not a big fan of Erin's sculpt. I think it's the teeth part, but I think also it depends on her face up. This one came out quite beautiful because of the soft colors on her makeup. She's very feminine, and I appreciate that in my dolls. So taking a closer look at her makeup, she has lavender-ish eyeshadow, and she has a very pastel-y soft pink lip color. So she also has the design that looks like the Versace logo on her earrings. They are quite simple earrings, but still very cute, and you can definitely, definitely reuse these. And then she also comes with hair clips, which I've put in already. Different design, and they have a different closure system, so they actually do snap on and off. So you can see here what I mean about the hair clips, different closure system, but very cute. She also has this adorable necklace with a little heart that dangles there. I really like it. It's very feminine. Again, she also has this bracelet, which is a very unique design, and it also falls off, so be careful. It has the bobby pin design concept going on. So I really appreciate that consistency. Here we can see her manicure is very cute. She has pointy nails with white tips, so that's very nice. And then on to her outfit, which is my least favorite thing about this doll. I am not 100% sure about the inspiration behind this outfit, but I have to say it's not my style. Let's not talk about where she's going dressed like this, but let's just look at what she comes with. She has this vinyl transparent dark coat. It has a belt which you can use. You get all this extra bit hanging here. I guess you could wrap it around or something. And then we have these little buttons which actually are quite adorable, and they do have closures here on the side. And then she has this slip dress which, to be extremely honest, looks like pajamas to me, but not really, because nobody sleeps with golden chains here, so I'm not really sure about that. It also kind of reminds me of AliExpress underwear, a reference that some people might not understand, but if you know, you know. The colors are actually quite nice, but I think for a doll that is this beautiful, she could have gotten a much better outfit, something more interesting to look at, I guess. This is very short as well. I want to show you guys the back of her dress. It's a very sexy look here. This to me looks kind of fragile, so I'm not really sure how long that's gonna last. And then she has sort of an open back area here, which is cool, I guess. And here's what she looks like without that coat. So yeah, like I said, I don't really see myself using this too much. The coat and the dress kind of reminds me of like 90s Barbies, and I do appreciate the pockets on the coat. You can even see them inside, but the material is already kind of foggy, and I don't know, I don't really like it. I don't really like this noise it makes either. I like the colors, like I said, but I don't like the idea or the design. It doesn't matter if it's Versace or Integrity, I don't like it. So I'm going to be redressing her because she is a really beautiful doll. Despite the fact that, like I said, I don't really collect Erin, but she came out really nice. Before I finish off this video, her hair is absolutely gorgeous. It's a very nice golden light brown color, good length, good style. She has these big curls at the end, which you can choose to wash out, but I think I'm going to keep it as is because she looks really pretty. She just needs a new outfit, more worthy of her goddess vibe that she's giving me. She comes with these really cool heels. They look very expensive, very fashionable, definitely runway ready. She also comes with this adorable black and gold wallet slash clutch that I think is very nicely made, and I will definitely be using it because it will match a lot of clothes, because black and gold tend to go with a lot of other colors. So I'm excited about that. And I believe that is all I have to say about this best friend duo for now. As always, thank you very much for watching. And I hope you guys got something out of this video. And I will see you guys next time. Bye!